And bodies of 17 martyred Jawans in Sunday's Uri terror attack will be brought to Srinagar today. The soldiers were martyred in the attack after heavily armed terrorists stormed an army camp in the town in the early hours. In a counter action, security forces gunned down four terrorists belonging to Jaish-e-Mohammed. Union Home Secretary Rajiv Mehrishi will visit Jammu and Kashmir today to assess the situation in the wake of the Uri attack.
At 5:30 in the morning on Sunday, terrorists sneaked into Rear Administrative Base Camp of Infantry Battalion in Uri town of Baramulla district in Jammu and Kashmir near the line of control. They threw several grenades and fired indiscriminately, causing the most deaths the army has suffered in a single attack in years. Most of the soldiers were burnt alive when their tents caught fire because of the grenades. The attack took place during a change of command, which means one unit was replacing another and soldiers were in temporary shelters. 17 soldiers martyred in the attack and around 30 soldiers were injured in a three-hour gun battle. All four terrorists killed in the attack belong to Jaish-e-Mohammed of Pakistan. DGMO, Lieutenant General Ranbir Singh, said some items recovered from terrorists were carrying Pakistani markings.
The firefight between the terrorists and Indian Army continued till approximately 8:30 in the morning. During this firefight, all four terrorists have been killed by the Indian Army. The killed terrorists, they were all foreign terrorists, and as per the initial reports, they belong to Jaish-e-Mohammed Tanzeem. Since the terrorists had some items which had Pakistani markings on that, I have spoken to the Pakistan Director General of Military Operations and conveyed our serious concerns about the same.
DGMO lauded the role of the Indian Army, saying that the Army acted in an extremely professional manner. He said the brave sacrifice by army is something to be saluted and that any nefarious design by the enemy will be thwarted by the Indian Army.
The Indian Army remains prepared to thwart any nefarious designs of the adversary. And any evil designs of the adversary shall be given a befitting response by us.
Army Chief Dalbir Singh rushed to Uri and took stock of the situation in the aftermath of the ghastly terror attack. In the evening, he briefed Defence Minister Manohar Parrikar, who also reached Srinagar to take stock of the situation in the wake of the attack. In Srinagar, Parrikar met Jawans who were injured in the Uri terror attack. Prime Minister Narendra Modi strongly condemned the cowardly terror attack in Uri. He assured people of the country that those behind this despicable attack will not go unpunished. He said, "The service of soldiers to the nation will always be remembered." PM spoke to Home Minister and Defence Minister on the situation. Home Minister Rajnath Singh reviewed security situation in a high-level meeting at his residence in New Delhi and briefed Prime Minister Modi on the attack. The Home Minister said that Pakistan is a terrorist state and it should be identified and isolated as such. He said that there are definite and conclusive indications that the perpetrators of Uri attack were highly trained, heavily armed and specially equipped. He expressed disappointment over Pakistan's continued and direct support to terrorism and terrorist groups. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley said that our neighbour is using terror to create menace in India, which is also supported by some stone pelters.
Pathankot aur Pathankot ke baad Uri, usse spasht hai ki aatanki hamlon ka sahara seema paar se jo taakatein hain, wo abhi bhi le rahi hain. पहले भी भारत ने इनका ऐसे हमलों का मुंह तोड़ जवाब दिया है और आज की घटना इस बात के लिए हमें तैयार करती है कि आगे के लिए हमें और हमारी सुरक्षा फोर्सेस को और भी तैयार होना पड़ेगा.
Strongly condemning the deadly militant attack in North Kashmir, Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti said it seems to be aimed at triggering fresh violence and creating a warlike situation in the region. While expressing anguish over the attack, she paid rich tributes to the 17 slain soldiers and extended heartfelt condolences to the bereaved families and also prayed for the early recovery of those injured in the attack. Security has been beefed up along the line of control bordering Pakistan and defense establishments. According to sources, the government has directed security agencies to launch campaign to eliminate terrorists. With Bureau Inputs, Rama Tyagi and Nandita Dagar's report, DD News, from Srinagar and Delhi.